now see
chapter 2, verses 1 to 8.
Chapter 2,
number 1, chapter 8. If there be therefore any consolation in Christ, if any comfort of love, if any fellowship of the Spirit, if any bowels and mercies.
Zvino kana kuvaraidzwa kweiko kuna Kristu, kana kunyaradzwa kworudo, kana kuyanana kwomweya, kana mwoyo munyoro nokudyira tsitsi.
Fulfilling my joy that you be like-minded, having the same love, being of one accord, of one mind.
Zvatisai mufaro wangu, muve nokufunga kumwe, muchiva norudo rumwe, nomweya mumwe, nendangariro imwe.
Let nothing be done through strife or vainglory, but in lowliness of mind, let each esteem other better than themselves.
Usikaiti chinhu munharo kana nokuzvikudza, asi mumwe nomumwe ngaati mumwoyo unozvininipisa, vamwe vanomupfuura iye pakunaka.
Look not every man on his own things, but every man also on the things of others.
Mumwe nomumwe ngaarege kutarira zvake oga, asi ngaatarirewo zvavamwe.
Want you to watch this verse here?
Church, it's a matter of the
past. Verse 5.
And number 5.
Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus.
Ivaiwo mumwoyo uyu wakanga uri muna Kristu Jesu.
6.
6.
Who being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God.
Iye kunyange akanga akafanana naMwari, haana kuona mhosva kuenzaniswa naMwari.
But made himself of no reputation, and took upon him the form of a servant, and was made in the likeness of man.
Akazvipiridza, akazviita muranda, akafanana navanhu.
And being found in fashion as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross.
Akati awanikwa nomufananidzo wemunhu, akazvininipisa, akateerera kusvikira parufu, irwo rufu rwomuchinjikwa.
Amen. May the Lord add blessing to the reading of his word. May we sit
here.
I want to give a thought to our subject tonight.
We
have not gone away from our series.
So I set the page on a series here.
I think the brothers must just know what number we are on, but we are giving these thoughts so that it can join up with everything else. The God man. God taking the form of a man. Amen. Looking at this as Jesus Christ was speaking on verse 5 through Paul here in Philippians in the letters. Amen. Because when you really want to see what the man is like, you have got to check what he's saying, and what he's saying is showing to you what's in his mind.
Because
the mind is the womb of the spirit, Brother Branham says that. That is where the conception takes place in you. In your thinking, your decision making. Amen. So we're able to tell who exactly you are and what you are aiming at when you look at your mind. Give us that verse again.
Tinogona kutonga some churches as well, so what can nanga nazo tikafanyika tikaona zvimufungo yako.
Amen. And when he's talking here about obedience, he's saying we must be ready to put away our mind, but take his mind in us. Amen. That is true obedience. When you're thinking of doing other things, because that's your decision, that's your mind, that's what you're looking at. Despite what you're looking at, you now see what he wants you to do. When you now accept to throw away your own and accept his, that is where obedience is. Amen. So this is why he's saying, Paul here is saying, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. It's quite a mouthful here. Amen. Because we know that all that was in God was poured into Christ. But where we are right now, we must throw away ours and we must accept the mind of Christ. Amen. Because the part of his manifestation is that the bride is the mystery of Christ revealed. I believe you are seeing the difference. That Jesus Christ was a mystery of God revealed. That was the message that Brother Branham preached to us. But right there he was showing you that in as much as Jesus Christ was the mystery of God revealed, we have come this far. Amen. Where the church has been made manifest. And now that it is made manifest, you are made manifest. Because the church is a combination of many brothers and sisters who have attained the same level of growth and maturity in Jesus Christ. So we become the mystery of Jesus Christ. Amen. Isn't that wonderful? Amen. And before I read my first quote, I want you to remember that the prophet told us that God will not allow you to do anything unless he has shown you an example. Amen. But in this case, he becomes the example himself. Amen. So you won't have an excuse to say, I cannot do it because somebody has done it. Amen. He has come to be with us. And he tasted the same afflictions and the same situations that we are also passing through. And he overcame. So that you too can overcome. But you know, it's not you that is overcoming, it is him in you. So after he overcomes, you come out in the open and say, I am an overcomer. Amen. And all you are doing is giving glory to the one that is overcome through you. Hallelujah. So before you become a God man, or a maid with gold on the inside. God must become, must come to be with us and take the form of a man so that we can do the opposite. Amen. If he comes down, you must go up. He comes into you, we must get into him. Amen. So tonight we are seeing what he has done. Amen. So that you too must know what to do. Praise the Lord. God taking the form of a man. The message of this hour is the only message that can let us know the plan of God for us in this hour. There is no theology anywhere that can do that. But we needed somebody that was able to climb into the mind of God and see what God is doing. And then he walks back to our level so that he can speak to us in our simple language, so that we can understand what God is doing there. Hallelujah. Is that right, brother, sister? If there was an age where the message has got to be preached, I want you to know it is this age. Hallelujah. Yes, there's been the preaching of the message all the way from the days of St. Paul. Amen. But they had part of the revelation. But we're living in a day. We don't have part revelation. Amen.
Yes.
Martin Luther had part revelation. Wesley had part revelation. Pentecost had part revelation. It was just getting to be increased bit by bit. Because it was all under Reformation. Is that right? But we are not in the age of Reformation. But we've got everything given back to us. Hallelujah. There is no regulation on the amount of revelation that must be given in this day. It is only you that is regulating it. But God has deregulated the revelation. Because this is rapture time. It is the time for your body to be changed. You can decide to accept everything so that you can move in the image of the Son of God. The prophet says, can you imagine a little fish in the midst of the Indian Ocean? And it says, I just want to drink a little bit of water in case I will finish all the water. Amen. He says it's also like a little mouse that's in the big harness in Egypt which Joseph had made. And it says, I want to eat one grain a day in case I'll finish all the wheat in this old granary. Brother, it's inexhaustible. You cannot finish the wheat. You cannot finish the water. Hallelujah. You cannot finish this revelation. Brother, the amount of revelation that God has unleashed to us in this hour,
amen,
is just too much. Hallelujah. Brother, you sink into it until you don't know who you are again. to be truly immersed and baptized in the anointing of this day. And you can never be the same again. If only you can come to a realization of what exactly you are doing in this hour. Amen. Because this revelation is not given for the denomination. It's for us. It is for me. I want you to say, it is for me. Do you believe that? Then let your body be under subjection. Because what you have just said, that it is for me. So you are not busy teaching it to somebody. No. But you say, it's for me. Praise God. And I want you to believe that God has got a purpose.
Amen.
In opening your eyes, to see what he is doing in this hour. Praise God, praise God.
Amen.
We shall preach, brother.
Amen.
And we shall talk about him.
Amen.
We shall talk about his goodness.
Hallelujah.
Come with me.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Paragraph 43.
Paragraph 43.
The mighty God unveiled before us. I want you to read a story from this book. Amen. So that you know where this story is coming from. I was reading a story some years ago. And in this story, it said a great noble king. I forget the name of him just now. I wasn't thinking about speaking of the story.
It
perhaps fiction, but it leads us to a point that gives us a background on what we want to say. This king, he was such a noble king and such a great lover of his subjects. Till one day, before his God and his royalty, he said, today, you see me for the last time. For many years. Hallelujah. And his God and his noble said to him, good king, why do you say that? Are you going to a foreign country somewhere and become an alien? He says, no, I'm staying right there. When he said, I'm going out among my subjects. Look at the reason why Brother took that story. Amen. About this king. Look at where he is going. He says, I'm going to be a peasant amongst my subjects. Amen. I'm going to cut wood with a wood chopper. I'm going to till the ground with a toiler. I'm going to prune the vines with those who prune the vines. I'm going to be one of them in order to get a better acquainted with what they are doing. And I love them. And I want to be more acquainted with them personally.
Amen.
Hallelujah. They won't know me. But yet, I want to be acquainted with them.
Amen.
Are you seeing that the mentality is
having?
But notice the title of the message that he is speaking in, the mighty God unveiled before us. And this is what is happening in the last day. Hallelujah. The mighty God, who was dwelling
between the cherubim, who was in the Holy of Holies. That's the one who is being unveiled before us. What a privilege.
Amen.
Sages and prophets of old never saw this.
Amen.
But you are seeing this.
Amen.
He is revealing himself to you. The Almighty God. Amen. Who was hidden all these ages past. But in this age, he is unveiled. What have we done to merit such favor?
Amen.
Hey, brother, you could have been born in the days of John Wesley. You could have been born in the days of
Pentecost.
Or maybe in the days of
Columba.
But in the time when the people of Columba were being born, God says, not this one. This one, not in Columba's day. You, I'm talking about
you. You
would have come that time. You would have come in the days of Paul. But God says, not this one. Hallelujah. Not this one. Not in the day of Luther. Not any other time. But he says, this one, and this one, and this one, reserve them for the last.
Amen.
You're the one that is coming now.
Amen.
Have you ever done a short relay? Did you ever do it at school? You think that you know what it is all about? Amen.
Man.
The one that must run the last is the best sprinter in the team.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen. The ones in between are mediocre. Amen. But you reserve the last part for the sprinter.
Amen.
Is that true?
Amen.
So you must say, I'm the sprinter.
Amen.
All the runners is from the days of St. Paul. God reserved the last part for you.
Amen.
For you. For me. Isn't that wonderful? These are the things you must be thinking about. It's not just a song. Make sure we finish all the stanzas. No. You must think about it. But
at
least something. In God's
economy,
He reserved me for the last. When you are sprinting on the last part of the race, you are the one that makes all the people who are sitting on the terraces to stand. When the first one goes, they are sitting maybe on the edge of the chair. Amen. The second one and the third one, they're all sitting and watching. But when the last one gets up, the bottom
line,
brother, if you have never known what goes on, you are a cross. When the last one comes in, the moment he hits the bottom stick in his head, everybody stands up with a
Two
bells, brother.
Amen.
There was a chant resurrection.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So they must rise first. Before you have a body change. Is that true?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We will not hinder them. But they must come up first.
Amen.
And when they are up from the grave, with a glorified body,
Amen.
That is the time. Amen. But this is where we get all our excitement. Amen. That we are arriving. When we read our papers, when we see everything around us, we are saying it's home going time. We must go. Praise be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Okay, let me finish this part. I was getting excited. Amen. We want to see this king. Amen. And the story is depicting what the king was doing. Our king. The next morning, when his delegates, all of his people, seen him, or the ones was in the palace. Take off his crown and lay it down upon the seat, the throne, and take his robe off and put on Pierce's clothes. Amen. Walk out amongst the common people. He was dressed like normal. Maybe with some overalls. Amen. And with some sandals made out of tires of some cow or something. So that he can just be like everybody else. He's hiding himself. Amen. Because his clothes of the king shows exactly who he is. But when he removes them and dresses like a peasant, he's
hideous.
Now, in that little story, we find out then about God. They say to the king, say, King, we want you. We love you. We want you to remain king. But he wanted to become one of them. To know them better. That they would know him better. Amen. Really, what he was. It would display to them what he really was. Amen. And that's what God did. He changed himself from being Jehovah God to become one of us. That he might suffer. He might taste death. He might know what the sting of death was and take the penalty of death upon himself. He laid aside his crown and his robe. Amen. And became one of us. He washed his feet with the lowly. He dwelt in the tents with the poor. He slept in the woods and in the streets with those who were underprivileged. He became one of us that he might understand us better and that we might understand him better. Hallelujah. This is what he has done. Praise God. The King of Glory. He left glory to become one of us. This is where this song comes from. Down from his glory. Ever living story.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Man.
He had to come down. He condescended to the man of low estate so that he might be one of us. This is what he did for us. Amen. But I want you to watch on another side. Amen. As I'm reading here 121 of the bridge message.
She made the paragraph 121, the bridge.
But the law required a kinsman redeemer. The law of God required a kinsman redeemer. If you want to mark that down, kinsman redeemer, find it in Leviticus
25.
Amen. We won't have time to thoroughly search this. Amen. Because you may text. Would make a night. But God's law received a substitute. Now, what if God had not offered to take a substitute? But love constrained him to do it. That man was without a way back. Hallelujah. And there is no way for him to get back. He was gone. By the grace of God, met this kinsman redeemer in the person of Jesus Christ. Law required it. Grace made its requirements. Oh, amazing grace.
Amen.
How sweet the sun.
Amen.
So you got to know some of these things. The law required it. But grace made the requirements. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So when men fell in the garden, he lost his level of godliness. Because Adam was made the God of this earth. And God remained the God of the universe. Of all the planets and everything. But man was given one place to rule over the earth. But what was in God is what was in Adam. Is that right? Godliness. He was an amateur God. Is that right? But when sin came in the garden, he was no longer an amateur God. He lost it out. So sin fell. Hallelujah. But God wanted man to come back to that level again. Is that right? So there was a chasm between God and man. Amen. This is where our story that we read about came started
here.
Because here is the king. He is living in the palace. But the woodcutter is out there in the wood. The pruner is out there. They are not in the palace. So we've got two groups of people here. Some are in the palace. Some are in the fields. They are not in one place. Hallelujah. Here is Almighty God. He is far away from men. And man can't get there because of his sinful nature. Hallelujah. But God had an idea. Because he knew it is him that put the law in the Bible of finding a way of closing up the gap between man who was fallen and God who remained in his own place. Hallelujah. This is why now he decided to come down. Amen. The reason he wants to feel the way man is feeling.
Amen.
He wants to cut wood together with man. So that the man must know. We have got a loving king. Who want to feel the way we feel. Hallelujah. Feeling hungry, sweating, and working, and doing everything. So down from his glory. Ever living story. This is where now the story in the book of Luke and chapter 1 comes in. Of how the king came down to be with us. I want to read that portion of scripture with you. Verse 26 of Luke chapter 1. Amen. It was a prophecy. But the prophecy became flesh. To be made manifest. So people must know what God had in his mind as a plan. Amen. And in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God into a city of Galilee named Nazareth. To a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And the angel came in unto her and said, Hail, thou that art highly favored, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women. And when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying, and cast in her mind what manner of salutation this would be. And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb, and bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus. Amen. He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest, and the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David.
Ye, uchaba mukuru, uchanzi manakoma na ukum soro soro, ishema adenchampa chikaro choushe, chaba baba David.
And he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there shall be no end.
Uchaba ta ushe, muimba ya Jacobo na kusika peli, na ushe waki, haonga zobani mukumo.
Then said Mary unto the angel, How shall this be, seeing I know not a man? And the angel answered and said unto her, The Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the Highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore also that holy thing which shall be born of thee shall be called the Son of God. And behold, thy cousin Elizabeth, she had also conceived a son in her old age, and this is the sixth month with her who was called barren.
We Talira, Elizabeth, Amayako, Naio, Wabanimi, Bayamanakomana, Wabichendera Kwaki.
For with God, nothing shall be impossible. The first time in the New Testament.
Testament.
And it's a message coming from an angel to bring this information among the human
beings
so that the human beings will be able to speak angelic language. Hallelujah! To talk about impossibilities becoming possible. Hallelujah. And Mary said, behold, the handmaid of the Lord, be it unto me according to thy word. And the angel departed from her. Hallelujah. Some 800 years before, Isaiah saw that in vision. And he wrote it down, behold, the virgin shall conceive. Hallelujah. So, for years, that scripture was just lying idle. When Isaiah died, they said, look, that scripture was not fulfilled at all. But if God says it, it doesn't matter what people say. It has to be fulfilled by God. Hallelujah. So God had a plan to come among men to fulfill his word. Hallelujah. So that God can become men. Hallelujah. Because there's a scripture to be fulfilled. Is that true, brother, sister?
Yeah.
This is where we are. We must know the plan of God and what he was doing for us. Hallelujah. So that when we see what he has done, we must also know what we must do. Then I go with you to the church ages. I take one little paragraph there. In the Ephesian church age.
Ephesian church age.
Amen. And page 99, paragraph 2. Amen. Brother Brennan was treating the issue of the serpent seed. How the devil came in among the human race. And the prophet is making a comparison of how God came in. And I want you to watch that the coming ins are different. Hallelujah. Now, in Genesis 3, there was a promise of a seed of the woman.
Genesis 3,
he's speaking here as the seed of the woman was literally God reproducing himself in human flesh. Because no man, a woman does not have a seed. It is the man that is for the seed. Is that right? But here's the paradox. Amen. That the woman is found with seed. And this is the Luke 1 that we're reading about. And the woman was Mary. And Almighty God, not Mary. Not Joseph, but Almighty God is the one that created a body in the womb of Mary. He borrowed the womb. Mary has no contribution whatsoever in the coming in of this body called Jesus. Hallelujah. And this is how God came into the human being, human flesh. So when Jesus was born, he was not a Gentile. He was not a Jew either. But he was God. Hallelujah. He was altogether God.
Amen.
Amen. So he had nothing
Amen.
But God provided a body. Amen. And it was that body that God had to anoint. Praise be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So the seed of the serpent is the literal way that Satan found he was able to open the door to himself in the human race. It was impossible for Satan. For he is only a created spirit being. So Satan was not able to reproduce himself in the manner which God reproduced himself. Because he was not a creator. So the Genesis account tells how he reproduced. He produced his seed and introduced or injected himself into the human race. Hallelujah. So this is the Genesis account. And we know how the serpent came in. The devil chose an animal.
Satan,
and he got into an animal. And he went to seduce Eve. Amen. And he mixed his seed with her seed.
Satan,
to produce a creature that had a body like the serpent. And with a spirit of a devil.
Mm-hmm.
Do you see the creature that came in? And the prophet said, God does not enter animal. But the devil came into animal.
Satan.
He's an animal also.
Amen.
Hallelujah. But God, he was specializing himself among the human race because he is not kinsman to animals. But he is kinsman to you and me. Hallelujah. So he created a body inside a woman. And when that body was born, it was a God man. God came among the human being. Amen. He spoke like a human being. God ate like we do. Dressed the way we do. Because that was his plan. Because he needed a kinsman redeemer. Angel is not kinsman to us. Amen. Animal is not kinsman with us. But God became a man. He felt the way we feel. He got sick like any other man. This what the prophet said. He says, verse 24, he says, I will see him sitting there on a stone with the head.
Amen.
He must have a feeling like me.
Amen.
So that when you are having a headache, you must know my Lord had this kind of feeling also.
Amen.
Lord, you are the high priest. Hallelujah. He knows it. He knows how it feels. So when you pray and ask him for divine healing, he knows how to come and help you out. Hallelujah. This is his brother, sister. He got hungry until the devil came to tempt him. Turn these stones into bread if you are son of God. But he was not a showman. We are not showmen also. He would have done it if he wanted. But he didn't want to do it for the devil. But after a year or two, we see him standing before 5,000. Who were all hungry? The way he was hungry than the other time. Yeah. Amen. And Peter is saying, we don't have money to go and buy food for all these people. And there's no shop even with enough food for all these people. We just want to make a plan. What can we do? Amen. So all the disciples didn't have a plan. But God had a plan. Amen. He was a little boy with a lunch box. Amen. With loaves and fish all packed up in that lunch box. Brother, it was not in a trailer. You know what Brother Bram says? It's a lunch box.
It's a lunch box.
Just a small thing. Enough for the boys' lunch.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
But he says, bring that boy here. He prayed for that bread. He prayed for the fish. Amen. And Jesus says, put them into groups. Amen. And he took the bread. After he prayed for it, he broke one and gave it to the other. Brother Bram says, when the one was broken, another one grew up. Amen. And he kept on breaking. He kept on breaking the bread and the fish. Breaking, growing, breaking and growing. Does he do it? Can he still do it today? Amen. He would have made the fish to go and lay eggs and let them hatch and grow big enough and then feed the people. How long was that going to be? But brother, he had to bypass all that. Because it was needed now. From the eggs, from the growth and everything, he had to make sure it all had to come on place. Amen. So, this time is not sure. But this time it's a miracle. Amen. From one little lunch box, they gathered 12 baskets of leftovers. This is what our God can do. When you get hungry, amen, you be a man of God. And say, Lord, you created that bread.
Amen.
And there were some leftovers. The Bible did tell us where they took the leftovers to. I know you don't have it. May I have some more? Amen. Brother, we're in a day of great troubles. Paradox.
Amen.
God can even answer your prayer there and there.
Amen.
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 Amen. And then you see some basket with bread and fish.
Amen.
Cooked bread and fish. Amen.
Amen.
Coming to you. You will never know who is bringing it. But is this the age? Is this the time? Are we waiting for another age for that? This is the time when these things have come to happen. Hallelujah. What we have come to, brother,
is
in our story today, or in our message. Amen. We are looking at a God man. God becoming man. Hallelujah. Because when he created the first man,
Adam,
he knew how that man was going to stand. What kind of ears and nose and mouth and everything? That's what he made for himself. Hallelujah. When he came on this earth, Paul calls him the last Adam. Hallelujah. The first Adam was a man. The last Adam is a man. Hallelujah. Coming from the hand of God to man. But he fell in the flesh. So God brings the last Adam in the same flesh to take man into glory. Hallelujah. This is the plan of God. And this is what he has done. Hallelujah. So John 1:1. In the beginning was the Word. And the Word was with God. And that Word was God. And that's not it. That Word was made flesh. And dwelt among us. And Peter said, we held him. We held his body. We shook him.
Something to eat around the tree, But the God man that was in him could take 5 biscuits and feed
5,000.
God was in his son, reconciling the world to himself. He is not going to let nobody tell you he was a philosopher. He was a good man. He was a prophet. He was God. Exactly who he was. I believe in his deity. Hallelujah. That's exactly what he was like. Are you seeing what is happening here? He was a man. The body was a man. But inside that body was a creator of heavens and earth.
Yeah.
He had to behave both ways. Is that right?
Yeah.
As a hungry man, he goes to the fig tree. But he sees no
figs.
Amen.
Yeah.
If it was a man who cursed that tree, the tree was still going to be alive even today. Amen.
Amen.
I know you're wondering. Today, after 2,000 years, we saw the fig tree where Zacchaeus
cried.
It is still there. Amen. But you see what, brother, sister? Amen. He was a man when he got hungry. But he was more than a man when he cursed that tree. And the tree was able to hear the voice of the Creator. And the tree had to obey. That's exactly what it was. Amen. I continue with it. On to the resurrection of Lazarus. As we're talking about the same thing.
Verse 91.
Amen. He says, now listen, you people here that belongs to this church. I'm not making fun and I'm not pushing this off to you, at you. Amen. Or it's Christian science.
I see Christian science.
But she said, if I prove to you that he wasn't, and he wasn't just an ordinary man, would you accept? I said yes. That was a discussion with this woman. Is that right? If you can prove it by the Bible, I'll prove it by the Bible that he was just a man. Amen. I said he was a man. Yes. Amen. But he was the Son of God. She says, well, he was just an ordinary man at that. I say he was. He was more than a man. He was divine. Said he wasn't divine, Brother Branham. I said, I'll prove to you by the Bible. I said, where will you prove it? She referred to St. John 11. She says, going to the grave of Lazarus, he wept. And he said, That proved that he wasn't divine. Because he could weep. This was a short-sighted woman, is that right? She only could see up to the weeping Jesus. I said, my man. I said, that argument is thinner than the broth made out of the shadow of a chicken that's up to death. I don't know how this short-sighted woman is
Shona can really express that, but it's one of those things. I said, that thing wouldn't hold nothing. I said, do you mean to tell me that that's the reason you believe he wasn't divine because he wept? She said yes. I said, when he went down to the grave, he went with me.
He
says that's true. But he was a God man. God was in Christ reconciling the world to himself.
Amen.
And I said, he was a man. When he was weeping, but when he stood there in the little pretty figure that he was, and a man that he had laying there 4 days, he stretched his little body and say, Ras, Ras, come forth. Brother, that was no more than a man. That was God speaking out of the mortal lips. A man that had been dead 4 days stood on earth and lived again. Hallelujah. His body was 4 days journey somewhere. I don't know where he was. Neither do you. So we won't argue about that. But anyhow, he had been dead 4 days. And when he said, Lazarus, come forth. A man that was dead 4 days. And skin worms crawling through his body.
When we said, jumpa, me,
stood on his feet and lived again. Brother, that was more than a man. It was. Do you see where we are, brother, sister? Amen. He was a God man. Amen. The God of the universe. He came to dwell in a body. So he was living two lives in that body.
Yeah,
hallelujah. He would live like a man. Get hungry like a man. Get tired like a man. But when the time come for him to express God, then he was more than a man. Hallelujah. This is the Jesus that we read about. What does he say? The Son can do nothing. But what the Father tells him what to say. Are you seeing? Hallelujah. So the body is as a body like a man. But there was God on the inside. Who tell him what to do? Amen. So God condescended to us men of low
estate
so that he could use our language. Dress like a man. Do everything like a man. But he was God on the inside. He died like a man on the cross of Calvary. He was buried like a man. But on the third day, he rose from the dead. He was more powerful. He overpowered death. He overpowered every other power. Hallelujah. And nothing could pull him down again. Till today. After 2,000 years. He's still alive. He will never go into the grave. So the power of God raised that body from the grave. And Romans
tells
us the same spirit that raised Christ from the dead dwells in you. The same spirit that raised
from the dead. Hallelujah. He's going to raise you too. With this, we don't talk about organization. We don't talk about church. We go beyond church. We talk about the power. God has redeemed you. It is the power that was brought to us in this day. The same Jesus. Is repeating the words. Brother, may God help us. May we realize what God has done in fulfilling the desire of the scripture in the law, which was desiring a kinsman redeemer. He has come as our kinsman redeemer. Hallelujah. And he was able to redeem us. Because a true kinsman redeemer. He must be related to the redeemed. He must be able to do it. He must be having money enough to redeem the one that is falling. Amen. It's not just a desire. It's not just a relationship. But must be worthy. And Jesus Christ, the worthy one. Hallelujah. It's him that shed his blood on the cross of Calvary. The devil could shed no blood for us.
Satan,
though he was closer to us. Because when we were growing up, he was growing up with us. He was teaching us to steal sugar. He taught us to lick up peanut butter. And the mother says, who has done this? And the child says, I don't know. But the lips are full of peanut butter.
It makes me remember what this other little story of this little boy, this little girl,
right? What are you doing?
You can't hide it anymore. Because the child is held up. You're selling yourself out. So that's what the devil was doing with us. Is that right? We were liars to begin with. But the devil could not hold us. Because there was a requirement of blood. Because he will never rise from the dead. If he is killed, he is killed for good. Amen. But there was somebody, Jesus Christ by name, is him that came down.
He gave me a message.
Amen.
So that you can look through me. And you can see your name. In the mystery at the time of his revelation. To make sure you can be redeemed. To make sure we can be healed. Hallelujah. The sinner can be saved. The sick can be healed. Because of the purchase of Calvary.
Amen.
You believe that, brother, sister? He can redeem you for good. Hallelujah. You can claim your healing. You can claim all you desire. Hallelujah. And that's why he went upon the cross as our kinsman redeemed. Hello from his glory. Ever living stone. Hallelujah. In the name of the Lord. We want to sing that song together. Amen. Because this is what he has done for us. Praise be the name of the Lord. Oh yeah, there's one.
Down from his glory.
Jesus.
Amen. When God calls you, He wants you to see His great plan. He wants you to see what He has done. The length, the breath that He has taken to come towards you so that He can get a hold of you, pull you out of your humanistic realm so that you can get into His own realm. Man was not looking for God. He was running away from God. Hallelujah. But Almighty God is the one that was looking for
them.
When you were running away, but He got a hold of you. He pulled you away from the road you were taking your
God.
So that He might wash you. Remove everything that is humanistic. Everything that the devil had locked up in you. From your body, from your spirit, from your soul. He wanted you to be like Him. We are so glad, brothers and sisters, to see this good plan that He had for us. We give Him praise. We give Him all the honor. This is what the Holy Ghost was given for. So that you can see His plan of how He became a man.
Amen.
So that He might take you and that you might be like Him.
Amen.
Man must be an amateur God
again
by the revelation of the word of the Almighty God.
Amen.
Lord Jesus, we come before
you.
We see this great plan. You condescended to men of low estate. You left glory above. You left your throne. You left your robe, Father, so that you might take the robe of man, a robe of flesh, and dwell in this world, Father, and to behave like us. Father, to see and to experience what man is experiencing. But through it all, Father, you overcame. Father, we want to thank you for this example that you've given us, that we can be like you. Father, we can see your plan of redemption. We can see your plan, Father, so that you can be like men, so that you can buy us out of the conditions that we are, because we have to be like you. Lord Jesus, receive praises, Father. Receive all the honors. You deserve, Father, to be praised. Forgive us, Lord. Father, when you expected a lot from us, Father, but we never did anything.
Hallelujah.
Father, that shows that we merit this, what you have done to us, Lord. Father, but we pray, give us opportunities that we can express God in our lives.
Hallelujah.
Father, when we live in our homes and places of work, Father, in the different schools, Lord, we want to be like
for this great plan that you've shown to us. Help us, oh God, that we can live for you every day of our lives. Father, I pray that you bless every brother and sister that was in divine presence this evening.
Hallelujah.
Lord Jesus, may we go out of this place,
amen,
Father, giving these praises and honor.
Hallelujah.
Knowing, oh God, what you have done to us. Knowing that the purchase from the cross of Calvary was sufficient, Father, for our salvation.
Amen.
Sufficient for our healing. Heal the sick, Lord, in our midst.
Amen.
Father, pray, oh God, that your grace, Father, will be shown in restoration of our health and restoration, Father, of the lives of your children, back in line with you again. We thank you. We appreciate you. We commit all into your hands in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.